Yo, what's good, new gang? Today I'm gonna rank into post-BTS K-pop inspired Filipino boy band SB19 Gold Viral, bro. A lot of you guys told me to react to this to get to know them a little bit, you know what I'm saying? It's finally here. Get on to the channel, subscribe to your boy, we're on the road to 10k subscribers. Help your boy reach 10k, smash the like button. Comment down below what else you guys wanna see next. The comment with the most likes of the song that I see the most of in the comments is getting reacted to. Appreciate everybody showing love to that, SB19 what music video reaction that I did. Appreciate everybody subbing up, commenting, liking, all of that. Appreciate y'all, you know what I'm saying? But today we're gonna do this. After this there should be like a live, it's a live performance. Anything you guys want to see, let me know down below. Comment with the most likes or the song that I see the most of in the comments is getting reacted to. I go about it that way because it's going to show me what you guys really want to see, you know what I'm saying? So pay attention in the comments and let's get it, bro. Gonna go SB19. Yeah, we gotta go.
So today we have SB19, a Filipino idol who has a very special and unprecedented background because they have been receiving hardcore Korean style idol training under a Korean management agency. So nice to meet you guys, and thank you for your time today. So can you say hi to our viewers?
Get in the zone. Great. Hi, BR. SB19.
Hello, everyone.
Gangsta.
I'm the most care.
I like that.
So nice to meet you guys, and thank you for your time today. So can you say hi to our viewers?
Get in the zone. Great. Hi, BR. SB19.
Yes, sir.
Hello, everyone. I'm the most charismatic member of SB19. My name is Josh.
I am the leader of SB19. My name is Sejun.
I'm SB19 heavenly voice. My name is Tel. Nice to meet y'all.
Hello. Just so y'all know, I'm watching this, right? But it's going to take me a while to kind of remember them. Like, who's who, you know what I'm saying? Just because of the fact that there's five of them. It's kind of like my Big Bang reactions. There's five Big Bang artists. And to this day, and I've done a lot of Big Bang reactions, to this day, I still don't know who's who, you know what I'm saying? So, just so you guys are aware, you feel me?
Hello, everyone. I'm the main dancer of SB19. My name is Ken.
And the youngest member of SB19. My name is Justin.
So, you guys are getting popular and popular these days. Can you feel that? That popularity?
A lot of things changed. We were just like, we could ride cheap jeans and buses, but like right now, we couldn't even get to like ride a jeepney and buses like a normal person without anyone recognizing our team.
So when did this begin, like this popularity?
I think from what I know, September 2, it was when we uploaded our dance practice video, and then overnight.
September 2, this dropped in 2019. You guys told me they debuted, either 16 or 18, I forget which one. But bro, the fact that, you know what I'm saying, either if it's 16 or 18, just the fact that all this exposure they're getting now, that's a short amount of time, you know what I'm saying? So props to them, good for them.
Someone posted it on Twitter, and then a lot of people noticed our group that these guys are great, they're very synchronized and whatnot. So we didn't really expect anything at first, but we were so overwhelmed.
That's usually how it is. I might do a little pausing here and there, you know what I'm saying? But that's usually how it is, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't expect that my reaction to SB19, I didn't expect that to do well, you feel me? So I appreciate y'all once again. But it's usually like that. It's like when you least expect it, something may happen, you know?
What happened, because like we didn't really expect anything. We're so happy and thankful to everyone.
Tell me about the activities that you're doing these days. You're getting busier and busier, right?
Actually, after we got viral, or after we got what do you call this, attention,
that's crazy.
We are getting lots of TV guestings, and we've been getting lots of attention in the Philippines nowadays. We're planning to have 10 concerts for 10 different cities in the Philippines nationwide, and it's gonna be the first time that it's going to be for free. Yes, and we're really planning it very well, and we're trying to prepare for it a lot.
I heard your song and I saw your music video, and I was very impressed. You guys are so good at dancing, right? So the practice, the training must have been really tough, right? Tell me about that.
About the training, actually, before we release our song, go up, we make sure that everything was perfect. And we practiced our song 1,000 times before we released the song.
Practice makes perfect. None's perfect in the world, obviously, you know what I'm saying? But practice is going to get better. That's crazy, 1,000 times.
And the dance practice, because we want to show everyone that practice will never betray you.
Ooh.
Oh, that paper, every day we practice.
Practice will never betray you. So, yo, so, somebody make that a global quote, please and thank you. Oh my God.
30 times sing and dance. Go up, and then we will put stamp every time we do runs. And then after, we will show it to our teacher, and she will.
Well done.
Well done. Every day, every day.
Wow. So I heard that there were more members.
Grinding, bro.
At the beginning, and the five of you recruited. Tell me about the other members who left.
Training for 3 to 4 years is really hard here in the Philippines without earning something.
There was more people.
So, and here in the Philippines, family is really important. You have to like give back to them the responsibility to help them with all the financial things. So maybe that's the turning point where they decide, I couldn't do this for this long. So
you guys receive a lot of comments.
So there was more people in this group, or how do you put it? Kind of like auditions, I guess, for them to, you know, join the group. Y'all let me know. Damn, bro.
Comments from your fans that you guys are really talented compared to other Filipino boy groups, right? What do you think is the difference between Filipino boy groups and you guys?
But we couldn't say that we are really better than them because we respect them humble. As well. I mean,
humble. We're not going to sit here and say we're better than them. Bro, humble. We respect them. Come. Bro, humble. Being humble is a good thing. Let's be real. It's a good thing. You know what I'm saying? They can easily sit here and say, nah, they're trash. Oh, they suck. We're the best ever. You know what I'm saying? They can really sound arrogant and cocky. Sometimes you want to be cocky, I feel like. You know what I'm saying? Just to, like, if you've been humble for so long and you, like, achieved something really nice, and you want to kind of, like, brag about it, go ahead. You know what I'm saying? You earned it. You deserved it. You worked hard for it. But humble. I respect them. I respect everybody else. We don't think we're better than them. You feel me? I like that.
Actually, we look up to many artists in the Philippines as well. So we don't want to consider us as better group, but all of us have different types of talents or, you know, unique style of how it would appeal to people.
What is Filipino style?
There's, we call it hugot. It means like, we're trying to get from our deep feeling. We're trying to express our deep feeling regarding to love experiences and something like that. Filipinos usually likes a very emotional thing, like
sad. Specifically sad songs.
Sad songs.
And then I've noticed that. Some of the other artists I've reacted to, it's Filipinos. Yeah, it's usually like, I kind of sense that, like, the people out in the Philippines, they enjoy music that's like kind of heartfelt. You know what I'm saying? They're you're pouring your emotions out type. You know what I'm saying? I sense
that. Go Up, the latest single of our group. It's called Go Up.
Ad.
Where you're going starts from where you've been. Yesterday, today,
bro,
tomorrow.
I like them, bro.
Always.
Go Up. Yeah, we gotta go up. They're chill, humble. I like that. That song sounds familiar. I think I heard it in a store somewhere in the radio. It sounds familiar.
There came this point that we almost gave up, almost separated, and then we talked like, maybe this is our last shot. This is going to be our last shot, and like we talked to each other. Let's get everything here. Let's pour everything here. So we decided to make a song about the story of SB19. It's about reaching your dreams and your hardships and everything. That no matter what happens, like if you.
Hey, bro, just to speak on that real quick, bro. That's facts. Sometimes you're gonna feel like quitting. I felt like that too with my channel. You know what I'm saying? So I'll just have those days randomly where it's like, do I really want to keep going? You know what I'm saying? But you got to keep pushing. Look what happened to them. Follow your dreams no matter what. Don't listen to nobody. Go with your gut feeling, your heart, your brain. You know what I'm saying? Follow your dreams. Do not give up. Because literally, and I said this in one of my older videos, not from them, but somebody else I reacted to. You're on your path, right? You're on your path to success, right? Right here, look how close you are. Right here is the success, the one that's gonna like make you explode. You feel me? Kind of like put you out there more. You're right here. You're feeling like you're quitting. You're stepping back. And it may be a day or two, but that one day can really set you back. And then you got to grind again for that success. You know what I'm saying? So it's like you never want to give up.
If you set your heart and your mind into something that you really want to do in life, you will be able to achieve it. You will be successful. And right. In time, everything
right.
Will, yeah. Will happen.
Work.
Then speaking of that, tell me more about your hardships. Like, why did you guys try to split up?
Fire.
What we're trying to do is a new thing here, and anyone actually here in the Philippines, performing is not a practical way of a living. Other trainings that we had before, yep. They couldn't handle the stress, they couldn't handle everything, and especially physically, you would be exhausted in training as well. So we are not sure about this path. It's like we have this a saying in the Philippines, suntok sa buwan. It's like an impossible way of trying to reach your dreams. So we just tried our best and tried our luck, and we just believed in ourselves.
So do you think you guys are getting closer to your dreams now?
Yeah, we're starting now.
We are starting. We're still far from our dreams, but we are slowly getting there, yeah.
Fire.
So I want I like to see that, what I you like can that. Show us.
Oh, like,
dude, you guys all have talents, right?
Let's start from the youngest.
Yeah.
I don't even have to wait till the sun hides, cause the brightest stars are the ones that live in your eyes. But love dies, where do I look up to the sky? We put my knees in the ground, I keep on asking why.
Wow.
Next is our main dancer.
Main dancer,
me.
Let's go.
Yay! We want to show the our ballad song, our debut song. 1, 2.
Unti unti nunuri ng aking nadarama.
Voice, bro, you got my voice.
Yeah. You're a great singer.
Yes, sir.
I almost cried.
Oh,
wow. Thank you so much. Unrequited love, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Thank you so much.
Oh. You deserve more attention.
Thank
I
you
think.
So much. Actually, for the record, he wrote the lyrics.
We help each other.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you guys write the song?
Write the song, choreograph the song.
All of ours.
Working.
Wow.
Working, so, come on.
I always watch this show in Korea called Show Me the Money.
I love that show.
Show Me the Money. And I have this dream of like joining the competition. So I tried to write a rap verse in Korean and English. What's up, non Filipinas? What's up? I came here and then I saw all that's left is to conquer.
I love when artists do that. They implement their language, where they're from, into their music. You know what I'm saying? I love that.
No panjagi, no mokuri, no got me son accessory. Ain't got no fancy jewelry and living a life of luxury. But from the southwest of this, I float from and took the risk. Biengi ganopi na jimo te so when yam yones kis mugo gitemuni
ah.
This is back to
K-pop song.
I need you, girl. Where? just I don't have on just some I need your head. I need you, girl. Where?
So do you guys have a role model, like a group, or what kind of group do you want to become?
We have lots of idols, especially in Korea. Personally, I like G-Dragon. Yeah, the common ground.
Bro, G-Dragon, yo. If you guys like G-Dragon K-pop, I have a lot of reactions. G-Dragon, the VIPs, they're fans, bro. They tell me that this man is number one, like, artist in Korea, bro. Number one, you know what I'm saying? And here he is, bro. An idol, somebody he looks up to, G-Dragon. I'm pretty sure everybody else does too.
The common ground, as a group, we look up to BTS. For me, I love Zico, Dean, and yeah.
I really like GOT7. My favorite member there is the leader, JB.
What's the next goal for you guys? Do you want to expand your presence in the world? Or like, do you want to take on another challenge, like acting and all that kind of stuff? What's your next goal?
If we're given an opportunity to act also, we would love to do that. But for now, we're focused on promoting our music all over the Philippines. And hopefully, if we're given the chance to perform internationally or globally, we would be honored and grateful to do so. We will always, always bring you good performances, better than yesterday. And we will always be humble.
Yes,
and
sir.
We will always, always remember what you have done for us. And we love you so much. I hope you keep on supporting us. We will go out.
These mans is some real men, bro. You know what I'm saying? Some real genuine people. Humble. You feel me? Like I said, like they getting all this fame and money. Like they can be dickheads. They can be cocky. They can be arrogant. You know what I'm saying? They can sit here and say, no, I don't look up to anybody. I do this all myself. You feel me? But they're paying homage. They say, nope, this one influences me. This one's my idol. This, and the third helps us be who we are, you know what I'm saying? Bro, I like them, you know what I'm saying? I fuck with them. That's my reaction to SB19 interview. If you guys want to see more, like I said, let me know down below. Smash the like button. Make sure y'all hitting that subscribe button too. Help your boy reach 10,000 subscribers. Comment down below what else you guys want to see next. Comment with the most likes. Song that I see the most of in the comments is getting reacted to. That's my reaction. If y'all enjoy, give this video a like. Subscribe if you haven't. And I'm out.